Today we're standing along the banks of the historic Salmon River. 200 years ago, in 1811, the first white fur traders came through here, close to where we're standing here today. My name is Peter Grauer, and we're in the heart of the Westwold Valley. It was towards the end of September in 1811 that David Stewart of the Pacific Fur Company, with his French-Canadian clerk, a Hawaiian assistant, and a First Nations guide, arrived here in what was originally called the Frenchman's Prairie. This is an original sketch done by the well-known and accomplished artist John Schnurrenberger. It depicts the moment that Stewart and his men first rode through this valley along the banks of the Salmon River. This was the first penetration by Europeans into the land of the Okanagan and Sequimic peoples. One of the first things the traders noticed when they entered the Westwold Valley were the vast meadows of nutritious grasses. These grasses provided fodder for horses even when it was dry and brown. In the winter, provided the horses could get the way down through the snow to reach the nutritious grasses beneath, they found sufficient nutrients to keep them through the winter. This first trip was soon followed by other traders, and the valley soon became the breeding and wintering grounds for the pack horses of the Northwest Company and later the Hudson Bay Company. The Hudson Bay Company journals make mention of the horses being wintered at Monte Lake and at Grand Prairie. Hundreds of horses were overwintered in this valley with its substantial amounts of nutritious grass and dependable water supply. When spring came and it was time to round up the pack horses, there would have been many scenes comparable to this early sketch of a Bay Company employee trying to bring the horses in. In order to look after these valuable herds, a cabin was built on the north side of the valley on a southern exposure to house those men responsible for looking after the horses. Located next to a small stream of fresh water that issued from a spring in the hills above, this little-known cabin gave the herders the basic creature comforts through the long and sometimes harsh winters. Probably manned by French Canadians and their First Nations companions, these early fur trade workers made sure that the horses and their foals were looked after throughout the winter. This is the location of the cabin. The creation of the plaque commemorating this fur trade cabin was initiated by the Westwold Women's Institute in 1958. This cabin could very well have been the earliest structure built by white traders in southern British Columbia. These poor quality photo reproductions are taken from a 1970s Westwold School newsletter. They are the only ones we have showing what the site looked like before the cairn was built. The original base logs can still be seen, showing the outline of the walls of the cabin and the big fir in the background that still stands. These large diameter fir trees close to the site most likely date back well before the arrival of Stewart and his party. Fortunately, neither fire nor tussock moth nor spruce budworm have been able to destroy these silent witnesses to our past history. The location of the cabin, protected from westerly and northern winds, serves as an excellent vantage point from which to view the herds of horses grazing in the valley below. The cabin was most likely built in the early 1820s by the Northwest Company and then taken over by the Hudson's Bay Company after the amalgamation of the two companies. This model of what the original cabin may have looked like is in a private collection in Westwold. As can be seen in these details, there would have been room enough for 2 to 4 people to live comfortably, if not in luxury. The site of this early fur trade cabin, carefully protected by the citizens of Westwold and the Westwold Women's Institute, connects this little valley to the very beginnings of the fur trade era in Western Canada. My name is Peter Grauer, and we are near one of the first white European structures built in southern British Columbia.